So you are using the Excel data connector in Power Automate or Power Apps, and this pops up. Error 400, file is locked for shared use. It is annoying, and there are several ways to resolve it. Here's one of them. Error 400. This is associated to HTTP requests that are failing to complete an action, whether it's a GET or a POST request, with that file. Now, this is not just locked for shared use. This has other situations where the error is returned. You could be posting an image to a CSV file, for example, and it just doesn't like it, can't do it. So in this situation, I'm going to recreate a common one where I'm going to take the Excel data connector, grab some data, and update it to columns in SharePoint. And this can't be done whilst the workbook is open. So before getting into this, questions that do pop up is, why don't they add a close workbook action to the data connector? Well, if you notice, there is no open workbook action either. Your flow is not opening the book. It's making a request to connect to a table within the workbook, or it's making a request to work with the sheets where the tables are. Excel Online handles the opening and closing of the book so that your flow doesn't cause a conflict with other users, other processes, or ends up just messing up the entire file. So we have to play the waiting game for the book to close. And that's what your flow must do as well. And there is a good way to do that. I'm going to show you. In this flow, I'm grabbing data from a row in an Excel table and populating columns in a SharePoint file. Now, it's important not to place Excel fields directly into the SharePoint properties, as it will keep the Excel book open indefinitely. Instead, store the Excel data in variables. Then use the variables to populate the file properties, never referring to the Excel connector again and allowing it to eventually close. We need to identify if the file is locked or not, so we will add an action towards the top of the flow and create an initialize a Boolean variable to store true or false. I'll call this one file locked. I will initialize this as true, assuming that it is locked to begin with. Optionally, you can rename the action to identify it. So we need to delay the update file properties, allowing for the file to close, but we need to repeat the delay whilst it is returning error 400. So we'll add a do until control to repeat the steps until the file locked status is equal to false. And I'll add the false expression as the value. I will now drag the update file properties action in as part of the repeated loop. But before that happens, I want to delay the action for a couple of minutes. So I'll add a scheduled delay and set the period to 2 minutes. I'll expect this loop to go around about 3 or 4 times at least. And that's fine, but I'd like the delay to run before the SharePoint update each time. So I'm gonna drag this above the SharePoint action. The last action to add is to set the file locked variable to true or false, depending on whether we get an error from the SharePoint update action. Now, this is lengthy code and I will add it to the video description below, but so we can understand what we're doing, I'll display it openly here and then I'll paste it into the expression. So we need an if followed by and, as we are checking for two things. The first we'll use an equals to test if any outputs from that update file properties. Status property within the body equals 400, the error number we are looking for. And we will use contains to see if any outputs from the update file properties message. From the update file properties, and it's the message property within the body we want to see if it contains the word locked. If both are true, set the file locked as true to continue the loop. Otherwise, false, because either it was successful or a totally different, more obscure error has occurred and we can't handle them here. Okay, let me just crunch that down to one line. I'm going to copy and paste that into my expression. Okay, now I want to set that variable whether the update file properties was successful or failed. So I need to go into the settings here and configure the run after to say only when it's successful or when it's failed. Okay, so it all looks good, he says nervously. I think the only thing left to do now is just test it. So yeah, save it first. Let's go to test and do a manual run trigger. So I'm going to start that up, but I'm going to do a switch to this account with, I've got Tess, and she's going to create a new quote and she's going to fill in some data. Let's put zippy and let's put a description and amount in. So here we go. So close the file, and that's already gone in. So let's go and test it and see if this works. And it's running already, and it's already got to the do until. So I'm just waiting for the 2 minutes to fire up. There we go. So it's actually taken 8 minutes. Let's have a look at that do until. So we've got four loops of this. The first one naturally is expected to fail. Yeah, there's the 400. And if I scroll along, there's the locked for shared use. So that failed, but it then went through the loop again as the file locked is true, and you can do it, see it failed there and there, and finally it actually worked. So it updated the data and that set the file locked to false. Brilliant, that worked lovely, and there's all the data just to show. Excellent stuff. Whew. Click like, click subscribe. I'm going to go through the list of questions. There's been quite an influx in the last few weeks. And I'm going to get through them and respond to them through social media. You can connect to me through Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, the usual. Any that are really big or get lots of demand for naturally goes into a video like this. So keep them coming, keep connecting, and I'll get back to you and work with those answers as best I can. Stay safe. And have fun.